Huh. Huh. And then you take a turn. This sounds like fun. Oh, hey everyone. Squeaks was just telling me about this fun game he played with Jessi. It's called Guess That Animal. Here's how it works. Squeaks and I each picked a few animals, but we kept them secret from each other. And now we're gonna take turns giving each other clues to see if we can guess what they are. Then we watch a video to learn more about them. Ready, Squeaks? You think I should go first? Okay, let's see. My first animal is pretty tall. It has long legs and a long neck. It has tan fur and two big humps on its back. Can you guess that animal? The fur means it must be a mammal, huh? You're right. And you can only think of one type of mammal with big humps on its back? That's right, Squeaks. My animal was a camel. Let's watch this to learn more about camels and the amazing ways they survive in the desert.
Squeaks and I are getting ready to go on a hike. I've got my big backpack with all sorts of stuff for both of us. Let's see what we got. We have a big bag of trail mix, a water bottle, and two cheese sandwiches, one for you and one for me. You're right, I think we are ready for our hike now. Squeaks, I just had an interesting thought. You know what wearing this backpack makes me think of? A camel. My backpack is kind of like a camel hump, and not just because it sort of looks like a hump. We're kind of like camels today because camels are some of the best hikers out there, and what's in my backpack gives us a clue about why. Take the sandwiches, for example. They're just like what camels keep inside their humps, fat. And a lot of it. This backpack makes me look like a camel with one hump, but there are also camels that have two humps. The humps are still the same, made of fat, but each type of camel has a special name. A camel with one hump is called a dromedary, or sometimes an Arabian camel. And a camel with two humps is called a Bactrian camel. A camel's hump can weigh as much as 35 kilograms, which is pretty heavy. It's like two of those gigantic bottles of water we use for the water cooler at the fort. All that fat gives camels lots of energy, which they really need. Camels live in the desert where they have to go without food for a long time. And by using up the extra fat when they need energy, they can survive for 3 weeks without food. Right? We can't live off our cheese sandwiches for 3 weeks, but along with the trail mix, they'll give us energy for the day. And cheese is mostly fat, just like a camel's hump. You'd need almost 200 sandwiches to get to 35 kilograms. Now that's a lot of cheese sandwiches. As a camel uses up the fat in their hump for energy, the hump actually shrinks down. And when they eat more, it gets big again. Another way we're like camels is because of our water bottle. A camel's hump isn't filled with water like this bottle, it's just fat. But camels can go a really long time without water, depending on the time of year. If it's summer, they can go almost a week without water. And if it's winter, they can go 6 or 7 months without it. We definitely can't do that. So how do camels go all that time without water? Well, when camels drink water, they can drink tons of water at one time, around 100 liters. That's about as much as a big trash can. If a camel comes to, say, a lake in the desert, they'll drink and drink and drink because it might be a very long time until they find another lake. And they can drink it pretty fast, too. It usually takes camels less than 15 minutes to drink all that water. Camels also hold on to water differently than we do. They don't sweat very much, so they don't lose much water that way. Although, they do still lose more water when it's hot out, which is why they need to drink more water in the summer. Camels don't pee that much either, so they drink a lot, and then they hold on to it. Now, there's one more thing that makes us awesome hikers like camels. Our hiking boots, which help us keep our feet firmly planted on the ground. Camels live in the desert, where the sand can be kind of hard to walk on. Think about how difficult it can be to walk through a big mound of sand, especially if it's windy out and the sand is moving around. And the desert can be rocky, too. So camels have their own version of hiking boots. Their feet are wide, padded, and pretty tough, so they can walk on the sand without any problems. And what about when it gets super windy in the desert and the sand starts blowing around all over the place? Yep, camels are totally ready for that too. They have big eyebrows, three sets of eyelids, and two rows of eyelashes so that sand won't blow in their eyes. Plus, they can actually close their nostrils when it gets super windy, so sand won't blow up their nose either. We don't have three sets of eyelids, and the only way we can close our nostrils is by pinching them shut. But then again, we're not planning to walk through any sandstorms today. With our food, our water, and hiking boots, we're prepared to hike like expert camels. Well, Squeaks, I think it's time to start our hike, and I can't wait to eat my cheese sandwich.
Okay, Squeaks, it's your turn. Your animal has eight limbs, huh? Some are really big, and some are really small. I think I might have an idea. And it lives underwater? I thought it might be a spider, but those don't live underwater. Oh, I know. Is your animal an octopus? Yes, I got it right. Octopuses are so cool and they're really weird too. Let's take a trip under the ocean to learn more.
Hey Squeaks, I have a joke for you. What did one ocean say to the other ocean? Nothing, it just waved. Squeaks and I have so much in common. We both laugh at the same jokes. There's also a lot about us that looks the same. We both have noses to smell, ears to hear, and eyes to see, and a mouth for eating cheese. Yum. But take a look at an octopus. Whoa. You're right, Squeaks. It looks like an alien from another planet. And it's no wonder you think that. A lot of movies and TV shows about aliens and monsters are inspired by the octopus, a mysterious animal from the bottom of the sea. An octopus isn't an alien or a monster, but it is very different from the kinds of animals we're used to seeing. Its body is built for the ocean, and it's very different from ours. For one thing, octopuses have eight arms. Think of all the fish you could catch with eight arms. For another, their blood is blue, and they have three hearts. They also have ink that can be poisonous. Some octopuses are very small, but some are humongous. The biggest ones have an arm span as big as a two-story house. And because octopuses hardly have any hard parts to their body, they can change their shape to squish themselves through very narrow spaces. That's why so many octopuses have escaped being captured by humans. They can fit through an opening the size of a quarter. Then there are all those arms, which are really more like arms and legs and fingers and tongues all rolled into one. Octopus arms are covered in suckers, little muscles that act like suction cups to help the octopus walk around, hold on to food, and feel and taste everything around it. And octopuses are very talented with their arms. Scientists have seen octopuses using their arms to open jars, throw shells at other octopuses, build walls out of rocks to protect their den, and even drag around two halves of a coconut. That way, when the octopus notices someone coming, it can close the coconut around itself and hide instead of getting eaten. But what makes octopus arms really special is that they can think on their own. Animals like you and me have brains made out of little pieces called neurons. And an octopus has neurons too, about 500 million of them. But more than half of those neurons aren't in the octopus's brain, they're in its arms. With all those neurons, each arm can take in lots of information and think about what to do next without needing to send any messages back to the brain. So if you were an octopus, you could catch a fish with one arm, walk around and explore the ocean floor with a few more, use your brain to help another arm do your homework, and still have an arm or two left over for video games. Since octopuses are so different from us, with their minds spread out all throughout their bodies, they don't think the way you'd expect them to. Scientists will sometimes take an animal into a laboratory to learn more about how it behaves. Most animals cooperate with the scientists, but octopuses? Oh boy. We've already talked about how octopuses are great escape artists, but they're troublemakers in lots of other ways too. Some have learned to shoot jets of water out of their tanks, sometimes at the lights, which can shut down the electricity, but sometimes they'll squirt it at people. Octopuses have also plugged up the water valves in their tanks and flooded the whole lab. And they can't be trusted in aquariums either. Sometimes octopuses will slither out of their tanks, eat the fish out of the tank next door,
and sneak back into their tank when the humans aren't looking. Octopuses sure are complicated creatures. They can also be very curious, and they like to explore and learn new things, just like us. So even though octopuses look very different from humans, maybe you're a little bit like an octopus. Squeaks, do you think that we can act a little bit like an octopus?
Okay, Squeaks. Ready for my next animal? My next animal is small, and it can fly. No, not a bat. I've got one more clue. My animal also grabs onto trees and hits its head against them really hard. So hard, it can make a hole in the tree. Strange, right? Do you know what it is? Great job, Squeaks. A woodpecker. Do you remember why they peck holes in trees? That's okay. Let's watch this to find out.
Squeaks and I are playing a guessing game. We're pretending to be different animals and guessing what animal the other person is acting like. Okay, Squeaks, take a guess. That's right! I'm pretending to be a squirrel. Okay, let's do another. Ready? Maybe I'll give you some hints. I have wings, I hold on to a tree, and I hit my beak on the tree like this. You're right, a woodpecker. Woodpeckers are a type of bird, and there are different kinds all over the world. They get their name because they all like to peck at things like trees, just like I was pretending to do. Most woodpeckers are black and white with some patches of red and yellow. But if there's a woodpecker nearby, you can usually hear them before you see them. Woodpeckers make loud calling noises that sound almost like a monkey, and they tap on trees with their beaks. To help them chip away at the tough wood in a tree, their beaks are long and hard. And when they peck, they move their heads back and forth really fast. So fast that it can sound almost like someone playing drums. Oh no, they aren't eating the wood, but they are pecking away at it to get a tasty meal. They're looking for something else inside the tree to eat. When a woodpecker begins to peck at a tree, they move little chips of wood out of the way, digging a hole until they find what they're looking for, like a tasty grub. A grub is a baby beetle, and some of these little insects like to live inside of trees as they grow up. Some of these grubs dig little tunnels through trees as they get bigger. So if a woodpecker wants to eat those grubs, first they have to use their beak to peck away at the tree, making a hole that reaches a grub tunnel. Then the bird uses their tongue to reach into the tunnel and pull out any grubs inside. Woodpeckers have super long tongues, so even if the grub is on the other end of the tunnel, the woodpecker can still reach it. It's a lot of work to peck through the tree, but they get a tasty snack in the end. What do you think, Squeaks? Can you pretend to be a woodpecker? You're a pretty good woodpecker, but you're a great rat.
Do you have one more for me, Squeaks? Your animal has four long legs, sort of like a camel, and it has hooves. And a short, bristly mane? Is it a horse? No, but I'm close. Okay, give me your last clue. Oh, it has black and white stripes, huh? I think I got it. Is it a zebra? All right, I got it. Great clues, Squeaks. Let's check out this video about zebras, and then we can see who won.
Hi, everybody. You're just in time. Squeaks and I were just looking into an animal mystery. We were looking through our big book of animals, and the last animal in the book caught our eye. It's a zebra. You've probably heard of them before. They look a lot like horses, but they have black and white stripes. Have you ever wondered why zebras have these special stripes? To find out, let's look a little closer at the life of a zebra. Zebras are closely related to horses, and they're a lot like them in many ways. They look a lot like horses, of course, and they run like them too, and they also eat grass like horses do. But zebras are also different from horses in some important ways. For one thing, horses can be found in many parts of the world, but wild zebras only live in Africa. Zebras also have hair on the back of their neck, called a mane, that's shorter and spikier than it is on horses. And of course, horses come in many different colors and patterns, but all zebras wear a coat of black and white stripes. But still, not all zebras are exactly the same. There are actually three different species, or special types, of zebra. Two of these species are named after the kind of place they live in. The plain zebra lives on the plains, where it's mostly flat and there's lots of grass and other plants to eat. Then there's the mountain zebra, which lives, you guessed it, in the mountains. The last species is called the grevy zebra, and it only lives in a few special grasslands in Africa. But all types of zebras have their famous stripes, and scientists have always wondered what these stripes were for. And this is what we're curious about today. Let's look at a few ideas about how these stripes might help zebras to survive in the wild. Some scientists used to think that zebras could use their stripes to recognize each other. It turns out that each zebra has a unique pattern of stripes, just like how every person, including you, has a unique set of fingerprints on their fingertips. Maybe by looking at each other's stripes, zebras could recognize each other and their families. But you don't recognize your friends by looking at their fingerprints, so we're not sure that zebras use their stripes that way either. After all, zebras have many other ways to recognize each other, like by their smell or by the sounds they make. So scientists have also thought that zebras might use their stripes to hide from predators. Lions and hyenas are two predators that often hunt zebras, so some have thought that the zebra's long stripes might help them stay hidden in the tall grass. But after looking closer, scientists noticed that the zebra's stripes didn't stop lions and hyenas from finding them. Instead, the predators used their noses to find the zebras by smell. They weren't fooled by the zebra's stripes at all. So maybe the stripes do something else. And there's one other animal that zebras need to keep away. Horseflies. Horseflies are big, pesky, biting flies, and they often bite animals like zebras, kind of like how mosquitoes bite people. But scientists have noticed that horseflies don't seem to like zebra stripes. Something about the pattern of the black and white stripes makes horseflies confused, so they stay away from them. So maybe that's it. Today, some scientists think that the stripes help zebras avoid getting bitten by horseflies. The stripes might work kind of like a built-in bug repellent. In fact, it turns out that zebras have the most stripes in places they really don't want horseflies to bite them, like on their faces. And many people have started using the answer to this animal mystery to help protect horses, too. Some farmers have started putting zebra-striped coats on their horses to keep the horseflies away. What an amazing way to use what we've learned to help our animal friends. It's important to remember that there could be more than one right answer to a question, especially when you're dealing with nature and science. So scientists are still looking at all of the other things that stripes might help a zebra to do.
Wow, what a fun game. Are you ready to see who won? Drum roll, please. Looks like we tied. I've got an idea. Let's go think up some more clues and play another round. We're gonna come up with some more animals. You can come up with your own clues at home too. Thanks for joining us today. If you wanna keep learning and having fun with me, Squeaks, and all of our friends, hit the subscribe button and we'll see you next time here at the Fort.